Welcome to our daily devotional for Friday the 12th of March. I'm Jeremy, a member of the ministry team, and today brings us to the end in our series through the Songs of Ascents. We're at Psalm 134. Before I read that, let's pray together. Heavenly Father, as we look at this psalm today, we ask you to lead us into your truth, that our lives may increasingly be to your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let me read Psalm 134. A Song of Ascents. Praise the Lord, all you servants of the Lord, who minister by night in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and praise the Lord. May the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth, bless you from Zion. I don't know about you, but these words take me back to a song we used to sing many years ago. And so it's hard for me not to break out in song, but for you, it's a good thing I don't. It's likely in this psalm that we have a greeting and a response. Initially in verses 1 and 2, a greeting from the pilgrims, God's people who have gone to Jerusalem, to the temple for a festival, and they're addressing the priests and the Levites. And then at the end, in verse 3, we have a response from the priests to the worshippers as they pronounce a blessing. Let me read verses 1 and 2 again. Praise the Lord, all you servants of the Lord, who minister by night in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and praise the Lord. So here we have the worshipping community calling on the servants of the Lord. That's the priests, the Levites, those who serve day and night in the house of the Lord, the temple, calling on them to praise the Lord. We read elsewhere of Levites being appointed to praise God. It was the role of those appointed to give praise and thanks to God, to sing his praise, to tell of his wonderful acts, to remember and recall what he'd done in the past, and to declare his glory. That was their role, their function, to give praise to God. Giving thanks and praise is a discipline, isn't it? Because we don't always feel like it, but it's good and right that we do. I worked for many years with a Bible correspondence ministry in Pakistan, and the staff team had always met at the start of the day for devotions, but we felt that we should introduce a time of praise and thanksgiving at the end of the workday as well. So we would pack everything away and come together to give thanks and praise. Now, we didn't always feel full of thanks and praise, particularly when it had been a tough day and there just seemed to be so much opposing what we were trying to do. But we would come together, somebody would read a passage of scripture, we might then sing a song, perhaps then somebody would recall something from the day for which we could give thanks, perhaps something quite small, but we could give thanks. Another song, a few more verses of scripture, more things to be thankful for. And so we would encourage each other and we would give thanks and we would praise God before heading home from the office. We chose to give thanks and praise. It was a discipline. It was good. And I've heard members of the St. James family doing exactly the same thing in Zoom calls over these past months. Challenging circumstances, perhaps, but I've heard them choosing to give thanks and praise despite the circumstances. And how encouraging it is. So how could you build praise and thanksgiving into your life and your times of prayer? Praise the Lord, all you servants of the Lord, who minister by night in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and praise the Lord. Then there's the response from the priests to the people who are gathered there. In verse 3 we read, May the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth, bless you from Zion. The priests speak God's blessing to the people gathered there. Let's pray. And as we do, we'll include what's in the prayer diary for today, the 12th of March. We read, "The carers group give thanks for this group meeting today. Pray that it will encourage those who are caring for loved ones, especially those impacted by dementia." And on the back, the country for prayer today is Bolivia. The same country as yesterday, actually, because some countries take more than one day to cover. So let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we acknowledge that you are the maker of heaven and earth, the one with all authority, high over all. You alone are God. And it is right that we recognize your unchanging qualities and declare your praise. Move us that we would more naturally be those who turn to you in thanks and praise. We pray that as the carers group meets today, they would know in a fresh way your goodness and love and your grace to sustain them through all they face. And Father, for your people in Bolivia, we pray that they too would have your praise on their lips and shine for you in that way, to your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.